Hello and welcome to episode number 92 of the TEW 2A Challenge Run. This is going to be SmackDown's first show for the year 2021 for Friday, week 1, January 2021, as the SmackDown side of the Royal Rumble build gets underway. Without any further ado, let's jump straight into the show. Okay, I'm so fucking happy with this. This is going to be a very wrestling-heavy show this week. Because we announced three big matches for the show. And one of them was this match, the 2 out of 3 falls final match between Dolph Ziggler and Robert Roode. And the Usos to decide who the SmackDown Tag Team Champions are going to be. And this is the fifth time this match has happened, actually, in the game. So I was worried it was going to get really penalised for being terrible. But it being a 21-minute 2 out of 3 falls match, it scored a 78 and it was the best match they've had so far, so it didn't get dinged at all. But in the end, the Usos once again come out on top, defeating Ziggler and Roode 2-1 after losing the first fall. Double superkick to Dolph Ziggler, wins the second fall, or the third fall overall and the second fall for the Usos, to win back the SmackDown Tag Team Championships. Just a quick title change I did for Ziggler and Roode because I thought it would shake things up and keep the shows exciting, but the Usos have won them back here on the first show of the new year. A nice, happy opener to the year as the babyface challengers win their titles back. 72 for Jey Uso, 70 for Jimmy, 73 for Roode, and 76 for Dolph Ziggler. We then cut backstage to Pierce and Bivens. Bivens has got a massive shit-eating grin on his face. Like, I see the first match on SmackDown in 2021. Bang, barn burner, absolute banger. And you know who booked that? Hey, Pierce, was it you? No, it was me, your little assistant here. And 2021 is going to be the year of Bivens as the assistant to the SmackDown general manager. Pierce is like, you know, yeah, that was a great match and you did book that, so kudos to you, but just don't let it get to your head, okay? I'm still the general manager here and you're still my little assistant. We then get a replay of all the events from the Christmas Chaos pay-per-view last Sunday, with Roman Reigns defeating Keith Lee, being found backstage in a bloody heap, and Brock Lesnar coming out and announcing he's going to be in the Royal Rumble after Mustafa Ali won. And Kayla introduces the new Universal Champion, Mustafa Ali. And he talks about, you know, Kayla, I'm old school, so me holding this goal, this means I'm the leader of this locker room now. For months and months and months before now, I've been sort of in the background, hacking away on my computer, trying to solve injustices and bring injustices to the limelight here on SmackDown. And with Corbin smashing my equipment, I'm no longer in the background, I'm at the foreground, because I can't sit back and look through cameras and deduct injustices. They have to show themselves to me. And as the leader of the SmackDown division, I promised you I will find the person who attacked Roman Reigns at Christmas Chaos pay-per-view. Because it wasn't me, obviously. I was looking forward to wrestling Roman for this title, but who knows if he's even going to make it to the pay-per-view at this point. And if he doesn't, that is the biggest injustice of all, and I need to find out who did it. And then Paul Heyman, but he interrupts that, Kayla, sorry, don't mean to interrupt. Again, Ali, I'd like to congratulate you on your massive win for the Universal Championship at the pay-per-view, and I just don't want to get any hard feelings in case you thought Brock Lesnar and I stole your spotlight. And Ali's like, you know, you're just the person I wanted to see, Paul, because it's really suspicious that you just happened to be in the building last Sunday. And a man that you've got a known history with, Roman Reigns, was found laid out. And he's like, what exactly are you accusing Brock Lesnar of, Ali? I can trust you. If Brock Lesnar had a problem with Roman Reigns, he would not sneak attack Roman Reigns from backstage and leave him in a bloody mess. He would confront Brock Lesnar would confront Roman Reigns face to face in that ring. And if you're going to continue to disparage the name of Brock Lesnar and you make it out of the Royal Rumble with the championship, you need to watch your mouth, because Brock Lesnar could easily pick to take that championship off you at WrestleMania. And then Heyman walks off, clearing his name, sort of, because Ali, he's got a list of culprits. Obviously, Paul Heyman's on it. And Paul Heyman's just trying to clear his and Brock Lesnar's name. Just to, again, double home. I mean, I told you during the pay-per-view that not to worry about Paul Heyman. But obviously, that wouldn't have happened in kayfabe. So this is just the kayfabe, them saying, hey, look, it wasn't Brock Lesnar. 80. Royal Rumble qualifier. AJ Styles defeats Braun Strowman in 7:26 with a phenomenal forearm. Not a Styles clash, because that's going to be impossible. After the interference from his bodyguard, Omos, to cement his place in the 30-man Royal Rumble match and banishing Braun Strowman to the abyss of catering. 80 for AJ and 81 for Braun. That's interesting. 74 rated segment. It's boss talk time with the former SmackDown Women's Champion. And she's like, it's no secret, I'm in a bad mood tonight. Last Sunday at the pay-per-view, I was screwed out of my women's championship. You see, my apprentice, Indy, she's young, she's inexperienced, she's learning. She didn't mean to accidentally hit me and cost me my championship. She shouldn't even have been out there at ringside. I don't even know why Adam Pearce let her out there. Because the numbers game was in my favour and I was being unfair. So basically, we should have that whole match revoked. So that match is unsanctioned because I was breaking the rules. My bad. But the match should be right from the history book and I should still be your rightful SmackDown Women's Champion. But more importantly than the SmackDown Women's title, we've got this Women's Royal Rumble coming up. And let me introduce you to some of the favourites from the SmackDown side who'll be in that match. Should be like Shayna Baszler, Bianca Belair, Bayley, Dakota. And they will get into sort of an argument, and it ends with Bianca and Shayna sort of getting into a brawl. And then, of course, Dakota would cheap shot Bayley. She watches on because she's the heel. And then when Sasha goes to leave, Ember Moon comes out of her new championship and she takes the fight to Sasha. And appears he breaks it all up. He says, look, we can't be having this. I'll deal with your situation with regarding the fact that we're a championship. I don't understand why you expect me to take your complaint seriously, Sasha, but I'll get back to you with something for you next week. But right now it's going to be Bianca Belair and Shayna Baszler one-on-one. A big time SmackDown Women's Division match and a big time win for Bianca Belair, because in 11 minutes and 6 seconds she beats the two-time NXT Women's Champion, former Raw Women's Champion, with a KOD clean in the ring with a 65 rated match. 67 for Shayna and a 47 for Bianca Belair. A big momentum swinging win heading into the Royal Rumble. Ali's backstage again. This time he's interrogating Tucker Knight and King Corbin. He says, look, I don't mean to brag, Corbin. That's not the kind of guy I am. I know for a fact if the boot was on the other foot, you'd be bragging to me about how you won. But I'm just here to clarify something, because you and Roman Reigns, of course, everybody knows you two go way back. And I feel like, quite frankly, your issues are only just finished. And you may have taken things into your own hands to make sure that Roman Reigns couldn't beat you at the Royal Rumble, because you had already written me off, King, and I could tell that. So you were looking into the future. So once you saw Roman Reigns won, you were like, I don't want to deal with that again. And you cheap shotted him backstage. That's my suspicions. And Corbin's like, man, get the hell out of here. First, if you stole my championship, now coming here to accuse me of this slander, you're king. You think you won. You think you won the Universal Championship and you're now the top dog here on SmackDown. Well, I'm still the king, and if you're going to come here and slander the king, he looks around, he's like, maybe I did do it, maybe I did attack Roman Reigns, what are you going to do about it, Ali, huh? And King Corbin's like, you know, I don't appreciate the bad mouth, so if you want to set up this in the ring in the main event and give me my rematch for my championship, then I'll be more than happy to do so. And Ali's like, taking whatever it would take to bring you to justice if you really did do it. So we're going to have an impromptu Universal title main event. Ali defends against King Corbin. VIP Nation then come out. And MVP says, well, Gable's already in the ring. He gets the jobber entrance, I guess. Sorry. And then VIP Nation come out. He's like, you know, there's been a slight change of plan. We've had a week to discuss this. 7 whole days. 5 since Bobby Lashley was on the receiving end of a shocking defeat to Apollo Crews at Christmas Chaos and lost his United States Championship. We've decided Shelton Benjamin's not going to be in the Royal Rumble match. However, the almighty Bobby Lashley, he will. Because he's lost the United States Championship to Apollo Crews, but he's got his eyes on the prize. He's looking to go to WrestleMania and win the Universal Championship. So, Mr. Gable, all you've got to do is sit back and lead by and watch Lashley lead by example as he gets you into that Royal Rumble match. So it's going to no longer be Shelton and Gable. It's going to be Lashley and Gable in the tag match to try and qualify for the Royal Rumble, because MVP feels Lashley's the ace of VIP Nation, I guess. And in a 79 rated match, Chad Gable and Bobby Lashley defeat Daniel Bryan and Apollo Crews. Gable pins Daniel Bryan yet again with a Chaos Theory. 75 for Gable, 69 for Lashley, 68 for Apollo, and 88 for Daniel Bryan. So, Chad Gable and Bobby Lashley, they cement their place in the 2021 Men's Royal Rumble match. And like I was talking about on Raw, it's even more apparent on SmackDown how some of the top guys aren't going to get in. It's just who I want to put in, get in to make the match the most interesting. So we already saw Braun fail to qualify, and now officially missing out from the SmackDown side of the Royal Rumble is the United States Champion Apollo Crews and Daniel Bryan. 75 main event. Ali defeats Corbin in 1350 with an 054 to retain the Universal title. Ali gets an 81 and a 75 for Corbin. But the main story here, believe it or not, is not the Universal Championship match. It is... I've put this in the wrong place. This is before the title match. Keith Lee's backstage and he's talking to Kayla about his match with Roman Reigns. He says, again, Roman Reigns was the better man last night and he knows his aggression got the better of him. But for Keith, it's all systems go towards the Royal Rumble because he hopes Roman Reigns can get back. And he hopes he can get to the Royal Rumble and win that Universal Championship. Because when Keith Lee wins the Royal Rumble, he'd love to run it back with Roman at WrestleMania. Then AJ Styles walks by, all happy because he won early on tonight. He's like, whoa, Keith, you're looking at the... You got a mistake there because you're looking at the Royal Rumble winner. It's not going to be Keith Lee. His name is AJ Styles. And that's going to be undeniable because I'm the most phenomenal wrestler on SmackDown. And then Keith's sort of like, well, if you really think that, an impressive win beating someone the size of Braun Strowman, it would have been cool to see you do it alone without this big guy helping you out. And he's like, what are you getting at, Keith? He's like, how about next week? If you really think you've got what it takes to win the Royal Rumble, how about me and you go one-on-one in the ring? And everyone else has earned their spot in the Royal Rumble. I've been talking about how I plan on winning the Royal Rumble. I haven't quite earned it yet. I don't want to just waltz in. I'm not Brock Lesnar or John Cena. So if you want me to earn my spot in the Royal Rumble, if you can beat me next week, I won't be a part of the match. And if I beat you, I'm not trying to take your spot. It's just me trying to prove my worth. And AJ's like, you're on. So it's going to be Keith Lee and AJ Styles next week for Keith Lee's Royal Rumble spot. This was the segment that actually does happen after the Universal title match. So Karsha Mine's back to that. Ali's just won with the 054. He's got the title in the A celebrating. We're on the Titantron. There is a mysterious... There's two hackers. I've accidentally left one off screen. By accident, it's my fault. And they're both obviously in ski masks. One's very big, one's small. And they've got distorted voices and they're like, hey Ali, your search is over. Because we are the ones who attacked Roman Reigns. And why did we do it, did you ask? It's only a matter of time. And then the screen cuts out and SmackDown ends. 78 rated show. That's pretty good. We didn't lose any pop. We didn't gain any pop. Blair. What matters more than the 78, of course, is what you thought of the show. So let me know before in the comments below. Very wrestling heavy show this week. But I managed to actually get a lot of story development in there. And I'll see you next time for episode 93, which will be Raw week 2 January. And Big E and Andrade will be going one-on-one on that show. Winner goes to the Royal Rumble, loser misses out. As well as more goodness from the Red Brand. I'll see you then.